I would subscribe to your channel if your hair didn't look like Sarah Palin. Hey guys, words do hurt, but there is no way. I had to look it up. There's no way that my hair looks like Sarah Palin. I mean, Johnny Tess, okay. I got you on that one. I'd probably say my hair is more like Donald Trump's than Sarah Palin. I more so think the back of his hair actually looks more like the front of my hair. And breaking news, this just in, Stanley Druckenmiller, any name with the last name of Druckenmiller, you know he's going to lose your money, missed out on 40%. And Warren, okay, you're 90. I get it. But I think at 90 years old, you know, Warren, when you've already won, you know, you got all the cash, you got stacks. Do you really need to be that risky? Now, I do respect both of these men, but to miss out on 40%, it's like you had one job, man. The largest 50-day bull run in the history of humankind. And they're just like, nah, I don't know. It's like Warren's, I'm all out. Airline stock, you know, at the very bottom. All out, everything. Just sell it all. And then after he hits the sell button, oh, this just in, American Airlines is up 170%. Forget it. All right, I screwed up. Buy it all, and then it plummets. So in this video, I'm going to try to teach you how to trade this market. Not financial advice, but how not to miss out on 40%. And there is a high likelihood that we're going to go in that direction. So I'm going to put up all those crazy charts, give you my words of wisdom. Don't listen to any. There is no wisdom in this noggin. But if you like business news, stocks, stonks, all that kind of stuff, how to make money, how to start businesses, and then with that, all that $2, what are we going to do with it? Would you at least just consider? You don't have to do it right now. Maybe in the next go around or the third or the fourth. Just consider subscribing. I mean, Stanley, you had one job, man. That was it. He says he was far too cautious during rally. Hedge fund legend warned about stonks risk reward last month. S&P 500 is up more than 40%. I think he grabbed about 1 or 2%. He's like, okay, we'll get a little right now. So hopefully, I don't know what his portfolio looks like, but he wasn't short in this thing. Whew, that would have been painful. Try to explain that to the people that trust you with all of their money. The shocking rally in the U.S. stonks has claimed another bear, Stan Ben Druckenmiller. The legendary investor who last month warned about owning stocks said on Monday that he now thinks he was far too cautious during the current market gains that are still gaining. It kind of reminds me of this. Okay, Stan, we're going to put you in this little plastic thing with $100 bills spinning all over and just grab as much as you can, as fast as you can, and then you come out with a dollar. Stan's like, but I was so distracted by his dancing. Before I show you how I trade this thing in less than 1 minute, Buffett, same thing. Oh, here's another. Do you guys see this? Wants to show you notifications, allow or block. My wife actually clicks allow. You should see. I open up her laptop and there were more notifications. I'm like, what is going on? I'm like, babe, I think you click the wrong button every time you go to every single website. Warren Buffett failed to capitalize on the bad word sell-off because of his age. Billionaire and come on, Ken. Don't throw shade on the poor 90-year-old. And as I'm filming this, oh my gosh, we have a pullback. S&P down 0.64. Gold is up. Oil's up 38. Up 38 bucks, down negative 40. Where are we going with that dem oil? But I do want to point out one thing. Right here, okay? If you have $140 billion of cash just sitting there, you know, you won, man. You go out with a smile. 104. How do you even spend a billion? Actually, I'm sure my wife would be up for the challenge. So just in case you were trying to connect the dots on how to make it to 90 with $140 billion is drink 5 cans of Coke a day. But he did change from Pepsi after 50 years. So I don't know. Is it the Pepsi that keeps you alive, or is it drinking the Coke? And this is for all you finger-wagging Wendy's out there. They're like, oh, you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't do that. This guy's going out with a middle finger in the air going, I consumed all of it and I'm now 100. My hope is that he doesn't use sunscreen at all. Ugh! My wife's like, put sunscreen on. I know, I hate that stuff. I wonder if Warren actually drinks alcohol. I'm waiting for the news articles that are gonna tell us that drinking at least one cup of tequila a day is good for you. Aha, thank you. Thank you, Google. 7 ways tequila is good for you. Perfect. You know, when you could just basically make any story work for you. And since we're on the story, you're like, okay, just tell us, what does it do? Okay, it's the go-to choice. Okay, yes. It will elevate your mood. Oh, absolutely. It will definitely elevate your mood. Tequila, low blood sugar, cholesterol. Okay, doctor. I have high cholesterol, so that'll work. Hangover powers. Yeah, it's not so bad on the hangover. I agree. Tequila numbs pain. And if you drink a lot of it, it probably numbs all of it. And it's less calories. And 7, cures the common cold. Okay. I feel the sniffles coming on. But really quick, let me hit you with just a couple stories before I show you how I trade this thing. It's official. The U.S. recession began in February. I think we kind of knew that. I just wish someone had the bowling balls enough to tell the stock market, hey, stock market, we're in a recession. Everyone's like, shh, don't tell it. Coming in from Bloomberg, looks like U.S. economy gradually stirs to life. But recovery will take some time. I really dig the recovery tracker. It shows in blue where everything's, you know, all good, and orange where it's worse. And it was just great in January. But in January, we were kind of feeling it, right? You're like, oh, I thought we were going to be moving into a recession. Recession 2020. I think I screamed that loud and long in 2019. And, you know, by the luck of the draw, I just happened to have got that one right. But it looks like, you know, we're starting to turn into some blues. Financial conditions has this as blue. It should be like bright blue. And like always, fundamentals, what's happening in the market, PE ratios, bankruptcies, just does not seem to budge this thing. Chapter 11, corporate bankruptcies filings recorded in May. So we are way up, and I would assume moving up quite a bit higher. So with all of this news, we have probabilities. When I trade, the market is based on probabilities. You know, maybe an 80-20, maybe a 50-50. And the higher we go, the more we pull this rubber band, the harder it will snap. You could go outside and throw that basketball up as high as humanly possible, but at some point, that basketball will come down to earth. And when it comes down, it is going to come down a lot harder than it went up. So I'll let you just look at this chart very simply, and then we'll go more into the technicals and go full featured chart. But, you know, like you're watching here, like, oh, okay, bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. Guys, this, even where it's at right now, is like historically impossible. But that's okay. We're there. So now let's dig a little deeper and let's see if I can teach you in 1 minute. Where would have been your entry point? Where would be your exit point? That's where you're pulling a little of the cheese off the table. And if you're looking at this color and you're like, yeah, why damn all those colors? You one of those libs from California, I gotcha. No, these are fib levels and they play a very important role when trading. And I'm gonna tell you, let me grab my little pen here and I'm gonna say the 50, this area was, I'd probably say everyone and their mother's, grandmother's, cat's, friend's, best friend was like, there is no way we are coming out of this zone. We're gonna come in, let me now clear it. We come down here, we have the bounce, we stay in here. And then we're like, okay, all right, I see you. I see you. Yeah, we're not going into the blue. We damn not going into the blue. And see how we like bounced around in here? And then all of a sudden we're like, okay, I just entered some kind of time machine or some kind of weird vortex. Now we're in a bull market? What? What happened? Like the fundamentals, the economy, all of the bad things. It's all really bad. Why are we even in this area is beyond everyone. But it's okay. We're here. We got here. Thank you to all of you Robin Hood 17-year-olds. You're like, well, I don't got school. I might as well just go on Robin Hood and buy and hold. Oh my gosh. There's so many people on YouTube that have that same mantra, right? Buy and hold. These guys have 1 million subscribers. Why not? It always works. Buy and hold. It always works until one day it does not and you lose it all. Or the people that are like, yeah, I'm financially all in. Actually, the technical term is I am fully invested. That means you are fully an idiot. You always have to have like 20%, 10%, 30% on the side. You do not go all in. Are you crazy? All right, let me clear out my Fibonuccis and give you three things that you guys need to know when trading this market. Again, not financial advice. You lose all your money, go talk to your broker at Robinhood. If it is up, God, man, that thing crashes. So you guys really need to move to Webull. They give you two free stocks. Link in the description. Looking at the first thing is the 20, the 50, and the 200 SMA. I am using software. You can get it for free online. It's called TradingView. I will forget to leave a link in the description where they actually give me something, but I always forget to put it there. But these are the lines that we're first going to look at. And what these lines are going to tell us is, are we in an upward direction? Okay. Or are we in a downward direction? So you can feel comfortable knowing. That's the first thing. Are we moving up? Are we moving down? Now, yes, on the daily, we could change it right here. If you look right about there, oops, wrong way, right about there. The 1 hour, I'm trading this on the 1 hour. If I move this on the day, you're going to see the same thing. It is a strong momentum moving in the upward direction. So I don't care if you're Druckenmiller. I don't care if you're drunken Berkshire Hathaway. You need to know these technicals of which way the market's going. I'll even draw you a little arrow channel that we're in. You see channels? We travel in channels. We're upward channel, downward channel, until we break a channel. This is all in my trading course that I, at some point in my life, I will launch. But if you want, I will leave a link for someone else's where they get all the money. 10%. I think you guys get 10% off. It might be $50, $75. I don't know what it is. Zip Trader U, Charlie, funny character. Just make sure that he drives the Lambo and I drive the VW. So you're going to want to set up, 50. I usually leave up the 20 for you guys. I don't have fit, a lot of things I get rid of. I clear everything. If I were just to like load it, you'd be like, oh, what's happening on your screen? I don't understand. But on this is a clear pattern that we are, it's a clear downtrend, right? Until we reverse out of that. And now we have to trade this market going up. So I even think like this dude right above my head, right? You could be a complete idiot. Watch, I'll teach you how to trade. This is trading for idiots. On the 200 simple moving average, see that gray line that comes right there? At whatever point that starts to change, I would say, right about there. All right. We are now in an upward, maybe right about there. We're moving into an upwards direction. So if you missed out on this section, okay, we got a problem. So now I am going to, we're going to get rid of one of those lines, kind of clean it up a little bit. So you can go, all right, one is a line that will show me how I am going to enter and exit on the swing trade. It could be a 1 hour, it could be a 1 minute, however you guys want to do it. It is based on momentum. You trade on momentum in whatever direction that you're choosing to trade on. But we're looking at trading this market in the upwards direction, also known as elevating factors. Think of it like my elevator that I come in and out of. This is moving up. So we have some elevating factors. Right here, we have these are elevating factors. The SMA is an elevating factor. The MACD is an elevating factor. The RSI is an elevating factor. These are all the things that are going to push a stock price higher. And then we have deprecating factors. That is downward. But right here, do you guys see in this area? This is all elevating factors. We are moving up and we are still going to continue to move up until we have an entry point, and I don't have an entry point on this. I would say that trading equities is a waiting game. For the most part, you're waiting. 90% of the time, you're like, doo-doo-doo. It's kind of like when you go fishing, right? You get out there, you put your, and you wait until, a fish bites. Now we can get active. On the 1 hour, I'll show you my entry points would have been one right there, one right there, Another one would have been here, but we would have lost money on that one. This one popped up right there, and then another one right there, and one right there that you would have ridden that one till right about there. Here's one right there, and that's it. This one, from here to where we are at right now, that would have been your last. Remember, you come in and it's one candle close above me, the 20, the red SMA line. That is where an entry, that is where you put in your $2, because we don't want you losing any more than two. That's it, just $2. So I'm going to zoom in a little bit so you can see it. There's no entry point yet. I have to wait. I need to see, let me color it so you can see something like do-do-do-do-do-do-do here, there, there, there. Maybe bounce off of the 50, that would be nice. And then a moment, not going down. You're not getting it down. You're getting it on the return when you have elevating factors shooting it up. But why not Johnny Bravo and buy it like when it's way down? Well, I don't know if it's way down because it could go way down even more. But if you haven't yet, like grab one stock or two stocks or whatever they give you, and maybe a crypto at some point. I think if you sign up for that instead of stonks, they'll let you trade Bitcoin. And then you get to lose all your money. And just use one and go, okay, all right, I get it. This makes sense, because if you don't do it, you won't understand. You could listen to me all day long. You can listen to other YouTubers all day long. But when you got skin in the game, it all changes. So let's just go down the list and see. Here, SPX, SPXS, that's long. If, again, that's the S&P 500 times 3. When it moves in the other direction, you can grab it that way. So when this thing flips, when I see this direction of this ETF, this is the bear, start to move in the other direction. There we go. Facebook. No, I'm not. I can't. I can't get in. Can't get in, Mom. Here, classic Amazon. Where should you have? And this is on a 1 hour. You don't have to be. Look, elevating factors. These are elevating factors. See those lines? The black line, elevating factor. Oh my gosh. Classic. Perfect. One. Done. One and done. Let that bad boy ride until it cools off down here. And we are RSI way overbought, and that's because everyone on their Robinhood, they're like, well, Amazon's going to be for, I'm going to just buy and hold forever. Until it drops. But this one, let's just add up the digits and see what you would have made on this swing trade. Currently, you're at a whopping 5 or 6%. Just take the beans off the table. Be ready for your next entry. That's how stocks are. It's waiting. It's fishing. You catch your fish. You pull it in. All right. You clean it. And then you wait for your next one. It could be a few days. It could be a week. You know, whatever. June. When was this? This was last week. And not all swing trades. Let me show you a trade that would not have played in your favor, right? That would have been one candle. And then, well, no. You know what? No candles. Actually, let me zoom in so you can see it. Gotta be accurate, Johnny Bravo. No lying. I know you guys are really technical in the comment section. Holy mother front door. So this, right, comes down. We come up one candle close. There you go. When you have one candle close below the red line, that is where you close your position. So it's like, ooh, almost. No, you would not have closed. It would have been a close call though. And then off we move until right there. Okay, so then you take your whatever percentages, 3%, 2%. Where did you enter this position here? And yeah, you're just looking at roughly 2%. But it's 2%, another 2%, another 5%. And it's when it shoots like 40%, you don't want to be on the drunken side going like, oh, shoot, missed that one. And here's a play that just, I was like clicking down. I'm like, oh, okay, TVIX. Another, here we go, whoop, one up, and on TVIX. Now, a lot of these stocks that I show you, and TVIX plays the long game, and it eats itself. I don't want to go into it, but just, you can't hold TVIX. You cannot hold SPXL. These are ETFs that will eat themselves over time because of fees. So you these are like a 1 week, 1 month kind of plays. Do not buy and hold. But also, I don't know if you caught this, this is not an elevating factor. So this is a dangerous play. Just like, let's take a look at gold. Gold is not an elevating factor. We are moving in the downward, let me show you. Do you see? This would be a time that we would have exited, probably already exited our position. We're waiting for the black line to reverse, so then we don't have a deprecating position. We have an elevating position that is moving in the upwards direction. And here's good old Bitcoin, where it is always a complete flustercluck. There is no way, because of whales and just to trade this using technicals, may the good graces of the Lord be with you. I taught my daughter probably a year or 2 years ago, maybe over 2 years ago, how I trade Bitcoin. And I only do this, I don't even care what the price is, which you don't ever want a trader to ever say that. I don't look at price. I actually only look at overbought and oversold conditions that you see right here. Anything in the white area, this is where you are buying, you are selling. And this is all she does. Buy, sell, buy, sell, buy. You guys get it? Sell, buy. And then this, you know, the queen in the middle. Yeah, I don't play that. It's just either way overbought or way oversold. And let the whales do what the whales do. I can't come up with rhyme or reason on Bitcoin. I mean, look at this trade on Bitcoin. What was it right here? To there within, you know, a matter of a couple days, it drops 11%. And I watch a lot of these YouTubers and they're like, oh, classic bull flag, I'm all in, and the thing dumps 20%. But you guys know, for you and me, at the end of the day, it's about starting businesses, like an invisible dollar, right? That's split in two, and you just never, wouldn't you think that you'd be able to see, like, okay, I can see behind it, right? Wouldn't you be able to see my face behind it? Oh, and the face is gone too. But if you want to know how to start businesses, and then with that said business, you earn income like this, you know, even though it might be in the invisible dollar that's cut in half, but I'll leave a link. You get two courses for $190-something. It's a 90-something percent off both the courses. Don't even ask, but I only give a couple codes away, so they go kind of quick. And if you've made it to the very end and you have not yet done this, or well, these buttons, I swear they don't work. Oh, now it works. Okay. How about this button? Will this button work? Oh, and we get a like, but I will see you tomorrow.